Hello and welcome to another Dave Campbell's Texas Football Talking Point. He is EJ Holland, I am Greg Tepper, and we are talking about the Texas State Bobcats, formerly the Southwest Texas State Bobcats. That's where my mother went, so I have to give SWT a little shout out. Talking Bobs, we're talking about their third year in the FBS. Going to be an interesting year for them, for Dennis Franchione. It seems like they've kind of plateaued a little bit, you know, a program that had a bunch of hullabaloo coming in as an FBS program. Now they're kind of getting left behind by UTSA. What needs to happen, EJ, for them to get to the next level?
Yeah, you saw both programs come in at the same time. It seems UTSA has captured the momentum, and it looks like they're on a path upwards, and Texas State is kind of stagnant there. For them to get better, I think, you know, they have pieces in place. They brought in a lot of JUCO players to fill in immediate holes. They've done okay on the recruiting trail. They could do better. This is an interesting question. I don't know if there's really a straightforward answer of what they can do better. I think Franchione and his staff need to do better in-game. I think he's a guy that could be on the hot seat if they don't increase on their five or six wins. They kind of need to win seven or eight, and they're going to be bowl eligible this year. It's going to be the first time that they are if they get to those six wins. So I think if they get to a bowl game, if they win a bowl game, and they continue that success, I guess that's what would help them get to kind of UTSA's momentum, I guess.
I think that Texas State is an interesting case where they need to trust the system, and it may go through some ebbs and flows. I think that this is a program that is heading in the right direction. I love what they've got at quarterback with Tyler Jones. I think that they're doing some good things in the recruiting realm. And what Dennis Franchione has said that he wants to do is he wants to get old fast. You know, he wants to bring in these JUCO guys to start right away and prop up this program. But they also need to increase what they're doing recruiting-wise in the state of Texas and get these homegrown guys who come in and stay for 4 years and stay with the program. It's still a young program. You know, even though they had great success at the FCS level, this is still a young program FBS-wise. They just need to kind of trust that process. And eventually, I think you're going to see them wean off of the JUCOs and wean onto more of the high school players. That's going to be an important transition. I think I disagree with you as far as Franchione on the hot seat. I think if they make a bowl this year, I think there's going to be a lot of things that go away, a lot of criticisms that go away.
If you make a bowl, all is well. But you're right. The thing about JUCO prospects is they're only around for 2 years. Mm-hmm. You need to build up guys for 4 years. And obviously, I understand getting old quickly, but eventually you're going to have to bring in some guys that you can develop, that can learn your system, that can really grow into FBS players. But yeah, if they make a bowl, it fixes everything.
Yeah, exactly. You want JUCO guys to get old quickly, but then you want your young guys to get old as well. So it's an interesting dichotomy there at Texas State. Well, that's going to do it for us. Log on to texasfootball.com for all things state of football. EJ Holland, Greg Tepper, we'll see you.